In the void of space, two Saiyans receive word that Frieza's been killed.
Looks like we get to go home after all.
Destination changed. New location, planet Lumbar. The pair are so excited to be back on their native planet, they decide to have a race home.
I won. No surprise, I always win.
You cheated! You took off before I said go!
Alright, we'll have a rematch someday, you sore loser.
A woman shouts the protagonist's name from below, demanding Doro get down there and give her a hug. Turns out it's his mom. And just like any mother, gives him a good smack for not keeping in touch. So good, in fact, it ends up breaking his scouter. Broko, the gentleman still in the air, gets a good laugh out of this until she threatens to smack him too. Deciding he doesn't want any of that, he chooses to take his leave now. Laughing off the situation, Doro's mother says she's gonna cook him a nice meal and they're gonna get rid of that armor. Being free from Frieza's tyranny, Broko decides to get rid of his scouter as well. Deciding it's been far too long, he decides to go talk to his mother too. Landing at a gravesite, he tells his mother that he's missed her and that they're finally free of Lord Frieza. And now he also has time to settle down for a family of his own. Doro gets plenty to eat and gets a more modern change of clothes. His mother goes on to explain that they're just like the clothes his father used to wear and how she misses them, when they're suddenly interrupted by a loud bang from outside. Quickly thinking and decided against that it could be Broko, he finds a large crater in his backyard. At the center lies a mysterious spaceship. The capsule opens and inside is an injured alien begging for help. Without hesitating, Doro offers to give his assistance to the visitor, but we're quickly made aware to his malevolent intentions. While flying him to someone who can help, the alien gets in a sneak attack. Doro tries to play pacifist and gets sent flying through the air.
He's so strong. What's going on?
Well, weaker than I expected. I'll finish you off and then I'll find your Saiyan friend. Then he can share the same fate as you. With Doro seemingly destroyed, the invader takes off in search for the other one. After hours of looking, he decides that he's had it. He's gonna make the Saiyan come to him instead. He begins to slaughter a village and sure enough, his plan works. Who are you and what do you want?
Are you ready to suffer the same fate as your Saiyan friend?
Doro?
Broko tells him that if he's struggling against him, he had no chance against his friend. The invader decides he's had enough of these games and sends Broko into the ground. Getting in a shot point blank, Broko can't even phase him. The alien goes on to say, "Do you understand now, you fool? It was fun while it lasted, but now it's time I get rid of you and I paint this planet red with the blood of your weakling friends." Unfortunately, Broko's rage can't propel him and he finds himself on his back once more.
Why? Who are you?
Well, I guess I can let you know the name of the person that took you down before I kill you. The name is Sega.
Why are you doing this?
Why, you ask? I remember it like yesterday, when those three tailed warriors came to my world. They claimed to be prospectors, said they came in peace. My people welcomed them with open arms. I was just a young child when they came, but I knew right away something wasn't right about them. And just as I expected from them, a few short hours later, they turned on us and began to slaughter my people. They said that the Katori, our planet's most plentiful resource, was now the property of Lord Frieza. But they brushed aside our warriors like wind would a flickering candle. They left me orphaned on a dead world, the damn Saiyans! They stole my life, my family from me! I will never forgive them!
Sega, huh? Stupid name if you ask me.
You!
The two get into a short back and forth before going at it. Sega thinks to himself that this guy's much more powerful than he initially thought, but there's no way a Saiyan has any chance against him. He checks on Broko, who says he just needs a moment to rest and he'll be back in the action to help him. Flying over, he asks the invader, "What's wrong? Are you stunned or have you just accepted the fact you can't beat me?" Quite the opposite. The alien said he just thought he'd give him a moment to say goodbye to his friend. Predicting he was just gonna jump back in the fight anyway, he kills Broko on the spot. Rushing over to his friend and ally, he realizes it's already too late. Enraged, the young man transforms into a Super Saiyan, quickly taking the advantage of the fight and almost delivering a finishing blow.
"Ha! Come out! I know I missed you, so why don't you just come out already?"
Exchanging minor pleasantries, the half-Saiyan goes back to whooping on the alien.
Huh. Well, what do we have here?
In Otherworld, it seems Broko has made it to the front of King Yemma's line, and has kept his body. Yemma assumes that he would like to go train with South Kai now. Before he can even answer, a mysterious woman shows up. She says that yes, in fact, that she would like to personally request that South Kai train this man. While her title is yet to be explained, her name is Ashu. But Yemma explains that South Kai is busy and requested not to be disturbed at this time, but he himself can train this man if she so desires. She gladly accepts and teleports away. Sega thinks to himself that the transformation he's been working on is not yet ready, and he shouldn't use it in battle. He knows he needs to come up with something quick, and that's when he remembers something. But first, he needs an opening. He knows this may only distract him for a second, but that's all he'll need. An explosion occurs in the distance, catching him off guard for that 1 second.
which is where this chapter comes to an end.